Can you talk a little bit about the Anti-Federalists' attraction to the Bill of Rights?
A Bill of Rights was the one thing that Anti-Federalists or opponents of the Constitution could glom onto because they knew that it was a popular argument. They knew that it was a rallying cry that many, many people around the United States might support, even if they had lots of other reasons for opposing the Constitution. Almost every state constitution by 1787 contained some kind of Bill of Rights, so it was something that was missing from the federal constitution that opponents could point to and say, look, this is another indication that we are creating a national government that will not respect individual rights.
You mentioned some of the objections that the Anti-Federalists had towards the Constitution. I'm just curious, before we leave the subject, are there any other objections that you think are worth mentioning that they had?
Anti-Federalists had objections, some of them, to almost any clause in the Constitution. I'll mention a few more that were particularly important because they speak to larger issues. The Necessary and Proper Clause in the section on Congress in Article 1 was of particular concern. That is, the idea that Congress should have powers to do anything, make all laws necessary and proper to enforcing the foregoing procedures or foregoing laws, that would suggest an almost unlimited grant of power to Congress. Opponents of the Constitution also saw in those very vaunted checks and balances all kinds of opportunities for corruption. For example, the president's treaty-making power. Well, it might seem like a check to have the Senate have to ratify it, but the Senate is really the more exclusive branch of government. This could provide an opportunity for the president to be in collusion with senators. So what delegates in Philadelphia might have described as checks, Anti-Federalists might have described as invitations to corruption.
Just have to ask, what issues raised by the Anti-Federalists do you think are still being debated today?
The debate between the Federalists and Anti-Federalists continues to resonate today. Those who say that the national government is seizing power at the expense of the states, those who say that increasing national government power will automatically, necessarily undermine the power of the states or the control of state or state sovereignty, they're echoing the arguments of Anti-Federalists. We are hearing the arguments of Anti-Federalists today pretty much in every election cycle. Arguments for more local control are arguments that reflect the ones Anti-Federalists were making in 1787 and 1788.